Okay, so basically what I've done here is kind of ran each resistor and kind of in between each position here. So basically what's going to happen is when we use this switch, we'll be adding a resistor for each position of the switch so that the Arduino board can use that value that it measures to select between programs. So I'm gonna, now that I've kind of threaded the resistor wires through these holes, I'm gonna go through and solder these together, and then I'll add the wires to the switch as well. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and solder these to the switch. Not quite sure about the proper technique for soldering. I'm sure there's plenty of tutorials on the internet. Just do a Google search and should get you going. Okay. Got a good solid connection there. We'll let that cool and then we'll cut off the excess leads off of this, so I'm gonna go ahead and leave the ones on the ends for just a minute here, because I do have to solder the wires to each end of this as well. Okay, I've cut the leads off of the excess leads off the resistors here, and now I've got three wires ready to go here. Black, a red, and a brown is the colors I'm using. Black and red are kind of the universal colors for power and ground. Red being positive or power, and black being the negative or ground. So I'm gonna go ahead and stick with those colors as we build this part, and that way kind of have a general universal standard with how we're doing this. So okay, got my three wires connected here. Power to one end of the resistor bridge, the red, the positive, and the black, the negative, is on the other end. And then the center point here, and what the Arduino will be sampling to get the value, is this brown wire connected to the middle lead on the rotary switch. So I'm going to go ahead and solder these to the okay. Now, as soon as that cools down a little bit, I'll cut the excess resistor leads off here, and we'll be ready to drill the hole and mount our switch into the project box. Okay, so there's one more thing we need to do to this switch before we get ready to mount it. This particular switch, the shaft is way too long, and the switch is going to stick way out of the box. So basically, with the knob that I purchased here to go with this, I'm going to need to cut it off about the length of the knob, just so that I can get rid of all of this excess shaft on the switch here. Now I've marked the shaft here where it needs to be cut, and I'm going to use a simple hacksaw to cut that off. Or my Dremel tool cutoff wheel. So you may not have the same issue, but if you do, you're going to want to shorten it a little bit too. Okay, so I've finished cutting off the excess portion of the shaft here. So basically this knob will slip right over the end of it, and there's not a whole lot extra, so it won't be sticking way out away from the project box. Now, one thing about this rotary switch, you'll notice there's a little tab up here that kind of sticks out. So basically what I'm going to want to do is drill the hole the size that it needs to be for the rotary switch, and then I'm going to also kind of cut a little notch in the project box so that this little tab will slip in, and that'll keep the switch from rotating around when we rotate it after we tighten it down to the project box. So I've already kind of marked a spot here on the project box, the lid of it here, so basically where this is going to mount is kind of in this open area here, so there's plenty of room for the back side of the switch when I put the top on. And next thing we'll be doing is cutting a hole on the side here to use for the push button momentary switch. That'll be controlled by the thumb as we're holding this while we're using it. So I'm going to go cut the hole for the rotary switch and make the notch, and then we'll mount that. Okay, so I've cut my hole for my rotary switch here, and I also have a little notch carved out here for the little tab on the switch to slip into. So I'll slip that switch in there, and this is where it sticks out on the other side, and then I'll use my little nuts that came with the switch to fasten it down securely and tight. Okay, I've mounted the switch into the box here, and I've also put the knob on the switch as well. Kind of position this so that it's got a little indicator on here, so that basically it's sweeping across the top. Doesn't really matter which position it goes into, you're going to be dealing with it in the dark anyway, so. Okay, now at this point we need to get ready to mount our momentary switch, and basically what I like to do is mount it over here on this side, because this will be the front of the tool where the lights will be mounted, and so I'll be holding it basically in this position, and that way I can use my thumb to push the button to apply power to it, and then I can just release it. And that way it kind of gives me control right there where I need it. So basically I'm going to mark this box probably basically in line with this rotary switch here, and mount this little push button switch right in this spot here so that it'll be right under my thumb. Okay, so I've cut my hole for my momentary switch here, and I've mounted it in. So now when all of this comes together here, I'll be able to hold the unit like that and use that to apply power to it. So switch programs and apply power and use the strip. So. Okay, now we need to start working on finishing the rest of our wiring here to the power and the battery and all that inside the box here. And then we've got to go ahead and mount our strip onto the wood trim here and solder some wires to it as well, and run those into the project box so that we can connect them to the Arduino board. Okay, I have cut up two more lengths of red wire here to attach to the switch, and I just kind of hooked the end of them and hooked them into the connectors there, and I'm going to solder those on. All of these wires so far I've just been cutting at length to about 6 to 8 inches or so, just to give me a little extra room to work with, and I'll cut them off to length if I need to. go ahead and solder these wires onto the switch now.